A couple of months back, I was sent an Octopus Home Mini, which is basically a clever little device that connects to your smart meter and sends live power data to the Octopus servers. You can then view that data on the Octopus app. Well, at that time, their official app was the only place you could see that data, but recently they have added it to their API, so you can grab that data pretty much anywhere you like. So today, I'm going to show you how to get that data into Home Assistant. Viewing live power data in Home Assistant is quite cool and can be useful too. I really like using the power cards to visualize how power is moving around your home. But obviously that starts with needing some way of viewing your live power in Home Assistant. The Octopus Home Mini is a CAD or consumer access device that bridges your smart meter and your Wi-Fi network. Now, using the Home Mini does come with a few caveats that you need to be aware of before we start. For this to work, you do need an internet connection at all times at the moment because the Home Mini talks to the Octopus servers over the internet, and you grab your data back from Octopus over the internet too. Secondly, the resolution of the data isn't that high, and by resolution, I mean it doesn't update very often. My experiments show it updates about once a minute, which is actually no worse than a lot of other cloud-based solutions I have, such as My Energy. You can't therefore rely on it for automations that need to respond quickly to power usage, such as solar diversion. But it will give you a rough view of your power usage and is definitely fine to help you view your baseline use. Now, when I started working on the script for this video, I was thinking I'd need to show you how to create manual sensors using a REST API, pasting in configuration and all that stuff. But at the end of Feb, good old Bottle Cap Dave, the author of the Octopus Energy Custom Integration for Home Assistant, went and added support for the Home Mini. This entire process is now a whole lot easier than I planned. Where to start then? You'll need to install hacks in Home Assistant. If you already have that, then fast forward a little bit, otherwise go and check out the link in the description to another one of my videos and follow all of the instructions there to get hacks up and running. Okay, so hacks is all installed, we now need to install the Octopus Energy custom component. Luckily, hacks already knows about this component, so we can just go to the integration section, click on explore and download repositories and search for Octopus. Now you'll notice this first one here is Octopus Energy and that's the one we want to install, so I'll click on that. We click on the download button, download again, and this might take a few seconds to install. Okay, once it's been installed, you will need to restart Home Assistant. You can see that it says pending restart, so I will go through and sort that now. While we wait for Home Assistant to restart, go and log into your Octopus Energy Online account. We're going to need to grab two pieces of information. The first thing you need is your account ID, which I've blurred out here, but it's up at the top. Then we're going to need to click on Personal Details. And if you scroll down the Personal Details page, you'll see this Developer Settings page. So click on the API Access button. Now, if this is the first time that you visited this page, you might be asked to generate a new API key. But if you've already done that, then you should see it listed here. It starts with SK_live. I've blurred out the second half of it, but copy and paste that into a text file along with your account ID for use in a minute, and then head back on over to Home Assistant. Hopefully it's restarted, so the next step will be to install and configure the Octopus Energy integration. We'll go down to Settings, Devices and Services, and Add Integration, and we should see Octopus Energy in this list. If I click on that, I'm going to be asked for my API key, so just off the screen I'm copying and pasting that in, so now there's going to be a lot of blurring going on so you don't see that. I'll need my account ID, which I'll paste in there. Now the critical bit is I have a Home Mini. You do have a Home Mini, hopefully, if you're watching this, so tick that box. You can fill in the other details if you want. Your gas calorific value is actually on your Octopus gas bill, so if you know that, you can fill it in here as well, and you can put your electricity and gas price caps in there, but I'm not going to bother for this demo. Click on submit, and hopefully any second now, there we go, success. You can see I've got two electricity meters and one gas meter. Now one electricity meter is actually my import meter and the other one is export for solar, so I expecting those, I'll click on finish. Now you can see it's created three devices and one entity at the moment. If I look at my three devices, there's my two electricity meters and one gas meter. Now you've got to leave this for a few minutes because it's only created one entity at the moment, and when I experimented before it took about 3 minutes. So just be a little bit patient, come back in about 3 or 4 minutes and hopefully there'll be some data. Okay, it's almost exactly 3 minutes later and I now know that we've got some data. So if I click on this first one here, this is my import meter, and you can see lots of little entities there, all showing how much energy I've used, how much it's cost. The one we're really interested here in though is the power. If I click on that, you'll see and some power data coming through. So this is the one that we might want to do something with in a power card or a gauge. So let's jump over to my dashboard and let's create a gauge. Right, let's edit the dashboard. I'm going to add a card and the card type is gauge. Let's delete whatever's in there by default. I'm going to paste in the entity for the power, give it a name of Octopus Power. Going to set the minimum value to -8,000 and the maximum to 20,000. That's obviously in watts. You can customize that as you see fit. Display as a needle gauge and define severity. Set the green to -8,000 and click on save and done. And we've got a nice little power output card. Obviously it's displaying 0 watts right now because I'm drawing from battery, but if I started to try and pull from the grid, then that needle would start moving around. See, it's really easy to configure. If you fancy more of a challenge, then you can look at using a power flow card instead of a gauge. Check out my power flow card video for more information on that, and I'll put a link in the description to that for you too. If you found this video useful, then please give it a like and don't forget to subscribe to my channel, because I really want to get those subscriber numbers up, and you'll get to see more videos from me too. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.